It all started with a simple enough comment.
In some instances, they've been subject to partisan distribution, so more distribution in certain constituencies than others, and that's just not fair.
Yeah.
I don't think it's fair to pit communities one way or the other based on what their provincial voting record has been.
But it turned into a war of words between the province and the Alberta Urban Municipalities Association, capped off by a scathing tweet from Premier Alison Redford's chief of staff Wednesday. It seems the war is now over.
I'd agree with that.
Ms. Sloan's explanation to me was that it wasn't misleading political partisanship that you give money to people who support you or vote for you, but that it was open to politics.
And the initial comments from Sloan that sparked the government's fury? Taken out of context, according to her.
I didn't expect it to be the flashpoint that it was, and I regret that it became the story.
Griffiths said he'll just have to take Sloan at her word, but reiterates there's no corruption when it comes to handing out cash to municipalities. But despite the United Front Thursday, Sloan still disagrees with that.
What we have said, what I have said, what previous presidents of AUMA have said, publicly and to members of government, is that the grant system has been subject to reduction, to change, and to partisan influence, and that is why we've had a problem with it. That's why it needs fixing.
The two say they'll now happily work together to develop a new funding plan for municipalities, something Griffith says may take another 4 years to hammer out. Tanara McLean, Sun News, Edmonton.